What did I say that we are going to learn today? Does anybody remember? Nobody. Nobody remembers what I told you yesterday. I told you not today, we'll do something. I told you to even read up and come. Did you guys read up? What voice? Yes, active and passive voice. Did you all read it up? Are you thorough with it? So shall I give you an example and let me see if you guys can convert active into passive voice? Okay. Okay. Okay, this is active converted into passive. Let me see. That is correct partially, but it's incorrect. The car was, that's good, driven, past participle, driven by Seth. Got it? Got it? We use the past participle form of the verb in the passive voice. Okay, in the passive voice, we use the past participle form of the verb. Okay, that is the rule. Okay, V3 form of the verbs will be used. Okay, so let me give you one simple example and then we'll start off with the exercises. Okay, because I don't want to spend too much time here. We've already done this before. Okay, look at the board carefully. Pay attention. All right. Okay. Stella teaches English in a primary school. Look at this. So what is going to happen over here in the passive voice is Stella is the subject. English is the object. Okay. So this interchanges. Okay. And when this English becomes the subject, you have to also look into the tense over here. This is given teaches. Is it the simple present tense? And English is just one subject. It's not plural. It's one English. So when you change it into the passive voice, it will become same thing. Keep it simple present only. For simple present, what we will do, say, we'll put is or are, right? If the subject is singular, we'll put is. If the subject is plural, we'll put are. So the rule is when you change it into passive voice, it will become English is, okay? Because English is one subject, English is, because it's simple present tense, okay? English is, now change it into V3. The teaches will change into V3 form. English is taught by whom? Stella in a primary school. Okay. All right. Look at this sentence. So this is in the simple past. Okay, Stella taught English. Now, if you change that into passive voice, if you change that simple past in the passive voice, English. Now, in the passive voice, what I mean in the past tense, what will come? The sentence is in the past tense. Stella taught English in a primary school is simple past. Okay. So change the subject to this side, object that side. So English was, because taught is past tense, so was. V3 form of the verb teach is taught and taught. So English was taught by Stella and the rest of the sentence. Okay. I hope you understood. One second. Okay, now future, you see, future, I'll write a sentence, the same sentence in the future. Stella will teach English in a primary school. Okay, so English, same thing, will, because it is future, we'll write will be plus the V3 form of the verb, taught by Stella in the primary school. Okay? That is simple future. For present continuous, we said ing is coming, no? So, Stella, okay, I'll give you another example. Richa is carrying a basket of fruits. This is in the simple, I mean, present continuous tense. Is plus ing. Present continuous tense. So change the object into the subject place. Subject into the object. So a basket of fruits. So the basket of fruits. Okay. A basket of fruits. A basket, it's one basket. So, is will remain as it is. Is, so when it is present continuous tense, we have to use being plus the V3 form of the verb. Is being carried by whom, Richa? Okay? Okay? Now, the same sentence, I'll give it in the simple past. Let me see. Richa was carrying. Okay, Richa was carrying a basket of fruits. Now, if we, oops. Okay, Richa was carrying the basket of fruits. Now, if you have to convert it, what will we do? Same thing, a basket of fruits. So was will remain, but what will we add? Was being carried by Richa. Okay, same thing in the future. Look into the future. Richa will be carrying a basket of fruits. Okay, future continuous. Okay, wait, one second. Do you have future continuous? One second. Simple past, present continuous. Simple past. Okay. Yeah. Yes. Not yes. The going to form of the simple future. So, for example, wait. Wait, not this example. This is a wrong example. One second. Okay. Pratima is going to write a letter. Okay. So, in the passive form it will be a letter is will remain the same, is going to be written. V3 form the verb written by Pratima. That's it. A letter is going to be written by Pratima. Okay. And future perfect tense, the same example. Pratima will have written a letter. This is in the future perfect. Will have written a letter. Now let's convert it into passive voice. A letter, same, will remain the same. Have been written by Pratim. That's it. Okay. Now, past perfect tense. Pratima had written a letter. Okay, this is in the past perfect tense active. Past perfect tense passive. A letter had will remain the same. Been written by Pratima. Okay, I hope you guys are understanding. Now, what is important is, so far, till last year, we have read this one. Okay. But now, what we will read is how we will change assertive sentences, negative sentences, interrogative sentences from active to passive. That is the most important thing that we are going to learn today. So, pay attention. Okay. So, if there is a sentence like this. I write a diary. It's in the simple present tense. Positive sentence. Diary is written by me. Passive voice. Now I'll write a negative sentence. Okay. You try to guess the answer. I do not write a diary. Okay, I do not write a diary. Same thing, bring that object in the front. A diary is not written by me. Okay, same thing in the interrogative. This one, do you write a diary? Is your interrogative question. Active, change it to passive interrogative. Is a diary written by you? Okay, is a diary written by you is the interrogative part. Now I'll give you another example. Okay. Another example, 1 second, please. One second. Okay, let's try this one. Okay, Varun is singing a song. Okay, positive, affirmative, present continuous tense. So, a song, present continuous tense. What is that? A song is being sung by Varun. This one all of us know. Okay, same thing, let's do it in the negative. Varun is not singing a song. Okay, a song is not being sung by Varun. Okay, interrogative, is Varun singing a song? Okay, change it into interrogative, a passive. Is a song sung by Varun? Okay, even in this interrogative also, this is affirmative interrogative, negative interrogative also is there. Let me tell you. Is Varun not singing a song? Okay, so passive, is a song not, sorry, is a song sung by Varun? Okay, is the song not sung by Varun? Okay, fine. So this is how we change active to passive voice when it comes to assertive, negative, and interrogative sentence. Now we have to keep these rules in our mind before we solve exercise A on page number 97. Okay, so I hope everybody is with me on page number 97. Okay. Okay. Fine. So rewrite, we'll write, rewrite these sentences according to the instruction. Okay, we'll rewrite these sentences according to the instruction. First one. According to the instruction, you have to read that instruction before. So who wrote this book? It's in an interrogative sentence. You have to begin by whom. Okay, by whom, and then build up your answer. Give me your answer. Let me see. By whom? Who wrote? By whom? Very, very good. Very good. Excellent. By whom was this book written? Okay. Over there, look into the sentence. Who wrote this book? Who wrote is what? Wrote is simple past. Who wrote is simple past. So when you change it into passive voice, by whom? Who? Okay. So it'll become by whom? Okay. That wrote is, because it's in the simple past, what is the rule for past? Was. Was this book, what is the V3 form of wrote? Written. Okay, so by whom was this book written? Okay, first one. By whom was this book written? Make sure you're putting question mark because this is interrogative sentence. Okay, next one. The tall man created a disturbance at the meeting. The tall man created a disturbance. It's again in the simple past. So, a disturbance was created by the tall man in the meeting. Very good. A disturbance was created by the tall man in the meeting. Third one, the dog was hit by a naughty boy. The dog was hit by a naughty boy. So, change it into passive. Was hit is again simple past. So, a naughty boy, a naughty boy. What is the answer? Naughty boy hit the dog. Very good. Very good. Very good. Very good. A naughty boy hit the dog. Okay. Fourth one. He will be elected monitor by the class. He will be elected. Will be is in the future form. Okay. So he will be elected monitor by the class. So what is your answer? The class will elect monitor him. Wrong. I mean partially correct, partially incorrect. Okay, the class, that will remain the same. The class will elect him monitor. Okay, the class will elect him monitor. Okay. That will be form. Look on page number 96 in your textbook, all of you. In that will be form, you see, Pratima will, Pratima is going to, this is what will be elected. Yeah. So Pratima will write a letter, same thing, will be written. So he will be elected monitor by the class. The class will elect him monitor. This is in the past tense. Passive voice, we are changing into active voice. Okay. Fine. Next one. Fifth one. He was known to be a kind man. He was known to be a kind man by whom? The people. Okay. It's understood. It's implied. The people. So, start with the people. The people. Knew. Okay, knew him to be a kind man. The people knew him to be a kind man. Okay, the people knew him to be a kind man. Sixth one, he was appointed principal. Okay, he was appointed principal. Who was appointed as principal by whom? They. So start with they. They appointed him principal. Okay, it's all these sentences are in the passive voice. We're converting them into the active voice. When the subject is unknown, it is inferred to as people. Like if it is plural, it is whatever they are saying. See, he was appointed by principal. So only one person cannot appoint as that person as a principal, right? It's a uniform vote. Okay, so there are so many people, so that is why it's written. They asked you to begin the sentence with they. Okay, seventh one, Hari opened the door. So the door, yes, Hari opened the door. This is in the active voice. The door was opened by Hari. Yes. The door has been opened. No. Look into the tense properly and answer the question. Okay. The door opened. I mean, Hari opened a simple past. So the answer also will be in the simple past. Only thing is you will add the door was opened. Okay. Eighth one. We prohibit smoking. So, smoking is very good. Prohibited by us. Ninth one. Keats wrote the poem Ode to Autumn. Okay. So, the poem Ode to Autumn was written by Keats. That's it. Okay. By Keats. Last one. We elected him leader. So, he was elected leader by us. okay, very good. He was elected leader by us. Okay, so what I wanted to do is okay, copy down. I'll give you one more minute. Once you finish, just tell me. If you've done, just tell me, then I'll give you homework. Okay. All right. So what I want you to do is, I want you all to do that B on page number 98. Okay, B on page number 98 as your homework. Do it as your homework and we will discuss the answers in the next class. I mean, now we have 5 more minutes time, but we're going to just brush up again. But please do that, complete that B as homework. Okay, is that clear? Did you all understand? Do you have doubts? Okay, tomorrow we will discuss B. Go out, I said. Go out. Go out. Okay, let's do C. Let's do C. You have to rewrite these sentences so that the verbs are in the active voice. Okay, the verbs are in the active voice. For example, not example, first one. We, let's do how much ever we can. We still have some time, okay? We are taught history by Mr. Ghosh. Okay, so you have to rewrite these sentences so that the verbs are in the active voice. The verb over here is taught. So active voice taught will is what? Mr. Ghosh teaches us history. Change that, all these sentences into the active voice. All these sentences are in the passive form. We have to change it in the active voice. So first one is, Mr. Ghosh. Mr. Ghosh teaches us history. Okay, Mr. Ghosh teaches us history. How do we know? How do we know that? What is that called? Is teach? No. Listen to me. We are taught history by Mr. Ghosh. Now the clue over there is, look for which tense is the answer. Are taught. Are is simple present. So change that into simple present active form. Mr. Ghosh teaches us history. Did you understand? Okay, are taught is a passive form. When we change teaches, we change it into are because we is plural there. Now change the same thing, reverse into active form. It will become Mr. Ghosh teaches us. Why it is us? Because it is we there. As history. Now do the second one. Let me see if you guys can do it. She was praised. So the clue over there is was praised. So was is in the simple past. Okay, simple past. So what will happen? The teacher praised her. Praised. You're not understanding. Why are you writing praised? There was praised is there. No, was is past tense, right? In that, wait, I'll share the screen to you. You people are getting a little confused now. we have one more minute. Wait, I this example I will tell and then I will stop. Look carefully, just this one example, and then you will know how to change the remaining answers. Okay, now look at this example. She was praised by the teacher. Okay, Jennifer ma'am, just give me 1 minute, ma'am. Okay, she was praised by the teacher. Now over here, what is that? You look for the clue. The clue is it's in the passive form. First clue is this one is identify that it is in the passive form. Okay, now the second clue is was. What is this was? Was is simple past. Praised is there. So bring this side. So the teacher praised who? She will become her. Okay, the teacher praised her. Okay, now tell me this one quickly. The injured were taken to hospital by the rescue team. Ma'am, just give me 1 minute, ma'am. I'm done almost. Okay, the injured were taken to the hospital by the rescue team. So this is all in the passive voice. You have to convert in the active voice. Okay, now what is the clue? Were taken is, were is simple past, plural. Okay, so the rescue team taken. What is the past tense of taken? Took. The rescue team took. That is the V2 form of taken. This taken is V3 form. Da? Change it into V2 form. The injured took. I mean, the rescue team took the injured to the hospital. Okay, the rescue team took the injured to the hospital. That is the answer. I hope you understood the clue there. Okay, the rescue team took the injured to the hospital. That's it. Okay, so keep these clues in your mind. Even when you're solving the above, I told you, B exercise. Okay, even when you're solving that B exercise, you have to change them into the passive voice. Okay, so do that homework. We will discuss the answers tomorrow. All right, so thank you. Bye.